different rules. I should just point out that the last fine you had was $5,000. This fine is $10,000. The next fine you get will be $20,000.
Well, since I was picked to be the least favorite player, Anderson offered me an exemption, and I took it.
Myra.
A group of strangers working together to earn up to $1 million. That in the end, only one of them will win. One of these players is the Mole, a double agent we hired working for us against the other 13. At the end of each episode, the players take the quiz, 10 questions about the Mole. The quiz determines who stays and who goes because the player who scores the lowest on the quiz is executed and sent home immediately. Up to $1 million hinges on discovering who is the Mole. Watch for the hidden clue to the identity of the Mole.
This thing is so many levels of complexity that it sort of defies the imagination. I mean, you cannot get to the bottom of this.
But it's so hard because we're down to 8 people, and that's really freaky. And you're hanging out with them, and you're like, kind of blows your mind that one of them is a freaking stinky liar and out to sabotage.
I hate executions. They just suck. They just suck. I wish there was a way we could play this game where nobody had to go home.
Darwin, why don't you tell us about your thoughts?
The Mole would be the person with the most exemptions.
You'd have to guarantee it.
What, yeah, both of you got 2 exemptions. Both of you, look at you. Sitting there with 2 exemptions.
Turn around.
Exemption face.
Maybe the mole never got an exemption.
So you're saying Heather's a mole?
Is she the only one who hasn't got an exemption?
Darwin.
Gribbs hasn't either.
And Darwin, the most suspicious of them all.
It's so funny. We spend at least 2 hours a day going like this.
No, excuse me, you do.
All right.
Exactly.
I do.
After 22 days, the pot stands at $236,000. 8 players have survived execution. They gather for breakfast in the hotel dining room, only to find a surprise from the Mole.
We come down for breakfast and we find a message from the Mole, and it is, "I will break you," attached to a gnome.
Each one of us has a gnome. All the gnomes are a little bit different color, which just generated a flurry of activity as everybody tried to write down the color and facial expressions of everybody else's gnome, since we don't know what's really important.
So I need you guys to divide up. I need 3 people who would rather watch Romancing the Stone, and I need 5 people who would rather watch Gladiator.
I'm Gladiator. I love Gladiator. Absolutely loved that movie. I had no hesitation on being put into that group.
Okay, I'll do Romancing the Stone.
Phil?
Okay.
So you're all in agreement? Mm-hmm. Phil, Heather, Bobby? All right, 3 Romancing the Stone people come with me. Let your people, I'll see you later in the day.
Welcome.
Thank you.
I think you guys are going to have fun today. Actually, let me rephrase that. I think I'm going to have fun today. You guys, I hope you have fun. Now, I've devised a simple relay race for you. The batons you're going to use in this relay race, they're kind of different. Let me show you.
Gnomes, I knew it.
I like to call this game Gnome Home, because the objective is to safely bring your gnome home across the finish line. Do that in under 30 minutes, you earn $30,000 for the pot. There is one catch. Your gnome, it's greased. That's right, using that big vat of lard, the gnome will be greased. You take your gnome, you put it in the vat, and you grease up that gnome. Okay? Make sure there's grease all over the gnome. You break your gnome along the way, the game is over. There is one exemption at stake today. I'll reveal that later. It's now time to choose your gnome. Heather, you will actually be allowed to touch the gnome before you decide which gnome you want to use. Now remember, you can grease your own gnome, but you can't grease your friend's gnome.
Smaller ones heavier, bigger ones lighter.
There are three legs to this relay race. I want you to decide what order you want to go in right now.
Let me go middle, just in case I can catch up and maybe give a little lead to the last person. Might make it easier on both of y'all.
Okay.
First, second, third. So first, second, third. So you've chosen the big gnome,
Rudy,
and you've chosen the order you're gonna go in. All right, let me show you the course. Follow me. Okay, Heather, this is your leg of the race. Start off with the hay bales, climb up the ladder, climb up the staircase to that lion. There'll be a Polaroid camera waiting for you. You need to get someone to photograph you with the lion and your gnome. You then take off down the boulevard. Bill, this is where you'll be waiting with your bucket of lard. You take your gnome. There's a soccer field. You basically have to try to score a goal. After you make the penalty kick, you want to get a photograph to memorialize the moment. Then get on that bicycle, put on your helmet, and there's an obstacle course that you will ride on the bike. At the end of the obstacle course, you'll come to a staircase where Olavia will be waiting. Olavia, you must take the gnome and place it in the stroller. You see the green arrows? You follow the green arrows on a course through town.
So we don't know how far Olavia has to go.
No.
I think this is a very tough game. I'm doing it in 30 minutes. I would not be surprised if Heather didn't get here for 30 minutes. I mean, she's got a long run.
All right, it is time. I never thought I'd say this. It's time to grease your gnome.
Okay.
So.
All right, so I start off by greasing the gnome, which was very interesting, and I realized that the game is going to be a lot harder than I thought because it's a lot slippier. It's slippier. Slipper. Okay. The gnome is very slippy. Where am I coming up with that? I think I'm just embarrassed by this entire conversation. So I have the gnome in hand. The hand, the slippery, and the movements. And I can't do this anymore.
I should point out before we begin that we're standing outside the city of Lucca. These are the ancient city walls which have defended the city for centuries against attack from outsiders. In a little while, we're going to proceed to the Lucca Amphitheater, where many epic gladiator battles took place. And today will be up to you to defend yourselves. But before we do, I need you all to pick for yourself a Caesar to defend. Now, I just want to point out Caesar does not need to fight his or her own battles.
Okay, so
I want to fight.
Yeah, but the picking who fights who.
Caesar is not trusted.
I don't think, right?
Rudis wasn't trusted.
Sounds like Dorothy.
Dorothy could be the mole. Dorothy is definitely suspect because she has pulled a couple of stunts, things that would keep her from contributing fully to games. She has no stomach for running or walking or anything. She lives in New York City, man. That's all you do is walk and run.
All right, Dorothy.
Please remove your hat.
Sorry.
It's your crown.
It's a wreath.
Now, you four are going to be defending Caesar against five gladiators. If the crown remains on Caesar's head at the end of the game, you win. $30,000 is added to the pot. If, however, the crown is removed from Caesar's head, you lose the game. All right? It is time to pick your helmets.
Can I try that one?
I like it, but it's catching me right there.
Oh, it does.
Yeah, good.
Can you see it?
No, it hurts my nose.
Right,
it doesn't fit.
Protection.
That really hurt my nose.
I'll wear it if I have to, but it hurts my nose.
That one fits you?
No. Is it fitting you better?
This one's fitting me better. Can you handle it?
Yeah, this one.
You sure?
Yeah.
In another part of Lucca, Bill and Olavia anxiously wait for Heather to begin the relay race.
On your mark, get set, go!
Luckily, Heather encounters an American tourist.
Excuse me, you speak English?
Yes.
Will you do me a huge favor?
I need your help.
Okay. Will you take a picture of me real quick? Over by this lion, it's for a game.
She's very hesitant at first. She seemed very shocked and actually a little bit afraid.
And I'm being timed, so. Yep, if you could just make sure and get the lion in the. Thank you so much.
You're very welcome.
Start running with the gnome, and I realized quickly that it's going to be difficult to run the whole way because I can't get a comfortable grasp of the gnome.
Sure is one greasy gnome you have.
Yes, there is.
Okay, time to get you guys outfitted. This is Caesar's outfit here in white. This is armor for the four guards. Now, In order to win this game, you have to draw blood, at least fake blood. Each breastplate has a lion's head on it. Underneath the lion's head, there's an egg filled with red dye. If you make a hit, you break your opponent's egg, and red dye comes out, you've made a kill. I'm gonna show you how you break the egg. You guys will be using these swords.
I was so nervous being the only girl out there, but it was one of my times to be like one of the guys.
All right, time to get changed into your outfits.
We have our shields and we're just, you know, constantly moving around her. They can kill us off, but if they touch Dorothy, the game's over.
So we wait until they get like almost to the front part, and then we just go bum rush the first guy.
Hopefully by the time the fifth gladiator comes down, we've already eliminated one of them so we can have an even 4-on-4.
Okay.
Okay?
All right.
That's the plan.
Bribs is the last player to put on his armor. And while the others wait in a separate area, I make him a special offer.
I assume you're pretty familiar with the story of Julius Caesar.
Yes.
You know, Caesar's best friend Brutus betrayed him.
Mm-hmm.
Ultimately, helped kill him because you randomly picked this helmet. And we call it the Brutus helmet. This helmet comes with a special offer. The offer is an exemption.
Coming up on The Mole, the next betrayal.
I'm being too honest in this game, and if I'm going to keep on going, if I'm going to start competing at a smaller group, I'm going to start having to be somewhat ruthless.
You have to be the only player in the amphitheater still alive. Your fellow teammates have to be dead, whether by from the hands of the gladiators or, if necessary, from your own hand. Then you have to kill Caesar, remove Caesar's crown. If you hand Caesar's crown to me, you earn an exemption for yourself. The group does not earn $30,000. You are not to tell the other players about this offer until after the game. You don't have to tell me one way or another for sure what you're going to do, but do you have any thoughts right now?
I can only do, you know, so much out there to survive, so.
All right.
We'll see. I guess it'll come down to the last minute decision.
It's going to become increasingly difficult to pass an exemption as the game goes on from this point.
Back at the relay race, Heather struggles to hold on to her greasy gnome.
I see Heather coming toward me. I think, boy, she's really sweating, and I realize it is grease that has melted and has run down her legs and arms. She is really a pathetic looking thing.
Way to go, way to go.
As Heather is greasing up the gnome, and it's really hard to say that without laughing, but as she is greasing up the gnome, I'm saying to myself, we have a shot at winning this $30,000. I run out to this little soccer field with a female goalie. I kick the first one or two fairly gentle, thinking she won't get to it. Come to find out, this female goalie is a pretty darn good female goalie. And so I start kicking harder and harder, and unfortunately, on about the fifth, sixth, or seventh ball, I kicked it as hard as I could and hit this poor girl in the belly so hard, I thought she was going to go down. But it did not go in the net. Let it go?
He actually had to get off the bike and run back and take a picture, and it took quite a while.
Okay, got the photo.
Are you gonna put it in the basket?
It's a good idea. I was trying to balance the gnome on the bicycle, and I didn't even see this basket. It was a good idea, because I think trying to hold that gnome and ride would have been real hard.
Are
Yeah, I'm okay.
Sad thing.
Well, yeah.
Once I started thinking about the movie Remains in the Stone, I had a strong suspicion that the exemption was inside the gnome. Since I wasn't 100% sure, and since I didn't necessarily want to just drop the gnome and just take the exemption and run, I just kept my suspicions to myself.
You broke the gnome. Don't earn the $30,000 from the pot, but you earned an exemption for yourself.
Well, it'll feel better a couple of nights from now. Right now, it didn't feel that good.
Yeah. So. Just because you're covered in grease, or?
No, just because I broke the gnome. I lost $30,000.
Sorry.
Hard.
I missed the little ramp, and I just...
Oh, it just fell off.
Yeah, you can see my wheel marks. I went off. I was going to hold the gnome under my arm where I could see and write. And Heather is the one that said, no, no, put the base of the gnome in the basket. It was only after that the basket fell off the bike and the gnome fell out of my hand and broke that I went back and looked at the basket. And the basket, it was held on by something, but I couldn't find out what. She suggested that very directly. So there have been subtle and not so subtle indicators that Heather is deliberately or accidentally sabotaging the game.
I was right. My initial feeling of the exemption being inside the doll was correct. He might have dropped it on purpose. I mean, I considered doing the same thing, so I feel frustrated because I really did give it everything I had.
Sorry.
At this point, I've gotten two exemptions. I knew that there was one in there, but I didn't want it just because simply it's getting to the point where we got to put money in the pot.
Yeah, if you remember the clue from this morning, the gnomes saying, I will break you.
Plus remains in stone, they break open the doll to find the treasure.
Right.
I think, feeling in solidarity, we should hug a lot of you.
Yeah.
We ought to hug you.
As the players march to the arena, Bribbs wrestles with whether or not he should accept the exemption offer.
I'm being too honest in this game, and if I'm going to keep on going, if I'm going to start competing at a smaller group, I'm going to start having to be somewhat ruthless.
We're going down the street, and just they're bustling with people. And people are stopping, and they're looking at us. And I was thinking to myself, man, I got to keep my game face on. But way inside, I'm going, this is great. So then we go into the amphitheater. And as we walk into the amphitheater, where there used to be, I guess, fights, we walk in, big circular building. Now there's a live audience. I'm going, holy cow, this is awesome. It's a live audience.
Everybody's excited at this point. We can't wait to play. In ancient times, many bloody gladiator battles took place here. We're going to go back in time today and stage a gladiator battle of our own. Caesar, that is your throne. If, at the end, Caesar remains on her throne with her crown on her head, you earn $30,000 for the pot. Caesar, you can go on your throne. All right, bring in the gladiators.
Here comes the other gladiators, and this is unbelievable. They've got the black robes on, the black shields, and the one big guy with the chainmail on and the horns coming up. He's got no shield because he's so tough. He doesn't even need a shield.
Oh, my God.
I had a sweat going. I was ready to go.
Coming up on The Mole, the next betrayal. In the Luca Amphitheater, the players are about to battle five gladiators. to win, they must defend Caesar and defeat the enemy.
When you actually see the gladiators coming, it's like, okay, that egg is fragile, so you gotta be either really aggressive or just be all out protecting your eggs.
Let the games begin.
All right, talk it out. Here we go. I come on top. Come on top. Come on top. Come on top.
Al's opponent draws first blood. Al is now out of the game. Only Bribs, Darwin, and Katie are left to defend Caesar.
All the smoke had cleared. The other gladiators did great. Our team did great. They killed them all, wiped them all out. We protected Caesarina, and it was wonderful. It earned us $30,000.
It was the biggest natural high I've ever had in my whole life. It was just so amazing.
It turns out I made a great decision keeping Katie in, because she killed one by herself. And she was clearly excited about that.
Al, get up. Come over here, join us. I was sorry to see you go down. Ribs, why don't you tell them what happened when you were changing?
After I finished changing, Anderson had told me that I randomly selected the Brutus helmet, thereby earning an exemption if I broke each one of your eggs and then slayed Caesar, much like Brutus did. In doing so, we would have lost some money and would have earned an exemption. And I decided from the beginning that I didn't want to play the game where I had to backstab somebody.
If I had to go through this game and be untrue to myself the whole way through, and if that was the only way I could win this game, I wouldn't do it. And I'm proud of myself so far.
Nice work, Bibbs.
Nice work.
When you give up an exemption, you give up, you know, a free pass to the next round. You take your chances.
But whenever anybody is offered an exemption and turns it down, it makes me wonder just a little bit, maybe they're the mole, they don't need an exemption.
Tough decision. Then again, you don't want to have everybody pissed at you for the rest of the time you're here either. And there's a lot involved. It's harder than you would think.
You wouldn't have actually technically been backstabbing anyone. It would have been more of a frontal slash.
Frontal assault. Yeah. Same thing.
Same thing.
Just as bad.
So you guys earned $30,000 for the pot, and had a very successful gladiator battle.
All right, let's keep on playing.
Yeah. Anyway, I thought it was an interesting day all around. Earned one exemption, another exemption was offered, turned down. Most importantly, you earned $30,000 for the pot, so the pot is now
$266,000.
As the evening progresses, the conversation turns to how everyone met their significant others or friends.
Heather?
I met him at a party, and we just said hello to each other, and he had a girlfriend at the time, but just upon, like, the hello, I decided that boy was going to be my boyfriend eventually. I don't know why, but we started dating.
So what was it about him when you first saw him that time that you were like, all right, he's going to be
extremely good looking, that's for sure. And so that was my initial deal. And I actually, my mom makes fun of me to this day because when I was little, I always say I'm going to marry a boy who has really dark hair and blue eyes. And that's what he looks like. So.
Bill, how'd you meet your wife?
Mine was very simple. I was over in an apartment building. I got up to head up the stairs, and a girl in a bikini headed up the stairs right in front of me.
That's right.
This is great.
And she had just the most wonderful ass, and I thought, you know, this must be a really smart person. I'd like to meet her, and that's the way I met my wife.
Really?
Yeah.
My roommate had a friend from home who was visiting and staying at our house. And I come home, and there is my soon-to-be boyfriend cooking in the kitchen. And I immediately demand that he play Scrabble with me. And there it started.
What if they went through the game only making three-letter words?
Hey, it's not in how long the letters are. It's all about placement.
Oh, my. All on the placement.
That is
triple words going.
You know it. All of the people that are my significant others really don't know it. So, and they don't really know I exist. So, it doesn't work.
Tonight, for the first time, the players will have their own rooms.
It's almost like the turning point where you realize it's an individual game rather than a team playing game, and you realize more and more that you're here for yourself and nobody else.
Having a room to myself actually feels pretty good because it's been a while and I like everybody here. But after a while, you just kind of want to have your own space.
Today, I lived out one of my boyhood fantasies. And so if I leave tomorrow, no grudges, no regrets. I will never regret passing up the exemption.
You know, on down the road, if I'm faced with the same type of situation, I would hope that I make the same decision. But that's not to say that I definitely would.
Coming up on The Mole, The Next Betrayal.
Each of you has a dollar bill placed in front of you. You're going to be using that dollar bill to rank your fellow players from your favorite to your least favorite. If I could have your attention for a minute. Tonight you face your seventh execution. Bill, you're safe from being executed because you have an exemption for yourself. The rest of you, however, are not quite so lucky. The mole is feeling generous tonight. There are no more exemptions available tonight, but I do have a game. Each of you has a dollar bill placed in front of you. You're going to be using that dollar bill to rank your fellow players from your favorite to your least favorite. It may sound familiar. Katie, you'll be the first one if you'll come with me. We'll go outside to do that. Is this list the same as the last one?
I think it is, actually.
Why is Bill your least favorite player?
I still don't trust him. I have that gut instinct about it.
What about Lavia?
I mean, every fiber of my being screams don't trust her. It's just the whole package. She's so calculated on her answers of questions, and she doesn't reveal much extra stuff. If at dinner, she never talks. She never shares. She's lied to me a couple times, and I've caught her in that. Thanks.
Hey, Lavi, do you have a seat? Why not alphabetical this time?
I don't know. It was kind of a cop-out the first time, so.
Dorothy?
I just like her personality, a little bit of a bohemian, just very, like, carefree, so.
Right. And your least favorite player, Katie?
Yeah.
Why?
Probably of all the players who are here, we just have the most, I guess, opposite personalities. Like, I'm just really quiet and she's really loud.
Lavi is now your favorite player?
Well, she's my favorite player because I really respect the way she's playing the game.
You trust her?
I trust her. As much as you can trust anyone in this game.
Bill, like I said, I wanted to hedge my bets. I didn't think he'd be last on anybody's list, so.
Dorothy's playing the game very well.
Bribs is, I don't know if it's really how he is, but he's extremely fair. He seems
to be.
I'm
able to figure Olivia out. I don't know if she's playing the game in a superb fashion or if she's not playing at all.
Dorothy is your least favorite player. What's that?
Dorothy is a great lady. She's a great gal, but I mean, she doesn't have an athletic prowess to her. She's, you know, pretty much shown that. Katie, she's a fun gal, but, you know, she can become a little irritating.
Unaware of the impact the list will have on them, the players continue with dinner, but some of the irritations surface.
Katie has a jelly phobia. It's the most ridiculous thing I've ever heard in my entire life.
How can we even see jelly? I don't get it. I just don't even get it. I'm just curious because I could see if it was like a bowl of it and you'd be like, go grossed out. But to be afraid and in a sealed package is so bizarre. I mean, the other day, Bribs had on packaged jelly. Ooh, but I'm like, it's not. Package. It could be anything in there. It may be sugar in there. You don't know. I'm sitting right now. You know what? I got a cup of jelly in here. Are you freaking?
Oh my God.
But there's none.
She's so desperate for attention that everything is exaggerated, so she gets that attention that she desperately needs and wants.
What's one of your fears? What was one thing that you're afraid of?
I've got no fear of jelly. Peanut butter, just a bit. Jelly? No, bring it up.
I don't know. It's kind of, don't you think it's a little weird?
I don't know why I fear it. If I knew, then maybe I wouldn't fear it anymore, but I do.
What is...
I have absolutely no idea what happened with jelly. Seeing it makes me feel like I'm going to vomit.
Don't be upset. I was just wondering. Just like unusual. What about jelly fish? Okay, I really wrote down the house for that.
All right, guys, I want to wish you a lot of luck on the execution on your quiz.
I had to choose who was going to be executed. I would pick Katie. Because I think she's still getting on my nerves. I think I'm starting to become a pain in her side as well.
Katie and I definitely share information, but the work coalition seems strong for what it is, really. I thought I'd come into it and work on trying to get everybody to suspect Katie and, you know, vice versa. Because she's so emotional, it'd be really hard to suspect her.
It is time for the quiz. 10 questions about the mole. Question number one. What color hat did the gnome have that the mole received at breakfast yesterday?
I feel that the difficulty of the quizzes, actually, they're getting harder.
Number two, what role was the mole during the gladiator game?
I think Rips could be the mole. He is playing the naive card a little too much, and that's always suspicious in a game like this.
Number three, what is the mole's favorite food?
I'm still very, and Heather as well, we're very suspicious of Olavia. We're gonna stay with our gut instinct.
Number four, what stage of the race was the mole selected to run during the gnome home game?
The reason I guess I volunteered for romancing the stone was because I thought Heather was gonna volunteer and then Bill did, so I was like, great, because they're some of my suspects for who's the mole.
He was very adamant about doing the second leg of the relay race. Just seems really suspicious to me. I mean, but he kind of got the exemption by fault because he broke it, but maybe he broke it on purpose.
I think it's somewhat suspicious that Heather says she knew about the exemption being in Dahl, but didn't do anything for herself, especially since she's been saying for so long that she wants an exemption and she hasn't had one yet.
Number five, how did the mole meet their significant other or friend? Number six, what is the mole's lucky number? Number seven, what did the mole wear on their head during their game yesterday? Number eight, how much does the mole weigh?
I was surprised that Al went out so quick because he was so pumped and ready for it and excited. Within like 10 seconds, Al, you're out.
Number nine, how many exemptions has the mole received?
Olavia. I've been suspecting her as being the mole from early on, and up to date, she really hasn't done anything that would make me think otherwise.
Number 10, who is the mole?
Gathered here in Lucca on a site with a rather long and gruesome history. This house was built in the 15th century to house the town's executioner. Prisoners were taken to the town square, beheaded, their heads put on stakes, then carried here, where they were placed in the ground outside the executioner's house. Here we placed Rudy, the gnome who did not make it home. Earlier this evening, I asked you all to make a list, ranking your fellow players from favorite to least favorite. I know a lot of you are curious to see how you rank in your teammates' minds, so I thought I'd give you just some information here tonight. Bill, you listed your least favorite player as Olavia. Dorothy, you said your least favorite player was Al. Olavia, you said your least favorite player was Katie. Al, your least favorite player was Dorothy. Bribs, you listed your least favorite player as Olavia. Katie, you listed your least favorite player as Bill. Darwin, your least favorite player is Bill.
One vote remains. Bill and Olavia are tied for least favorite.
And Heather, your least favorite player is Olavia. What interested me most was to find out who, as a group, you selected as your least favorite player. And you selected Olavia. Can we come up here? Tonight, I'm going to offer you a bribe. In this suitcase is $49,992. There's an additional $8 here, which contains the offensive list which you and your fellow players used to rank each other. So all told, that's $50,000 cash. The bribe is this. You can take $50,000 if you walk out of the game tonight.
Oh my God.
Up on The Mole, The Next Betrayal.
My main motivation was never the money, because I came in it for experience. So it's really a tough choice for me right now.
Olavia has been offered a bribe of $50,000 if she walks out of the game tonight.
You have no way of knowing how you did on the quiz. You could be executed tonight. This is a guaranteed $50,000. The choice is yours.
Now, is this coming out of the group pot?
No, it's not.
Like, my main motivation was never the money. So to kind of be put in this situation is a little weird, because I came in it for the experience. It would probably be a good choice to go with the money, but I hate quitting. Any suggestions, guys?
That's guaranteed cash, Olavia.
I think I'm gonna take my legal counsel's advice and go for it.
You're gonna take the money?
Yep.
Take your bag.
Thank you for not liking me. I'll see you guys.
Bye, Olavia.
I didn't think there was any chance in hell that she was gonna take it. I thought she was a mole.
Olavia's the part just screws me in a big way. Everybody has a pecking order. And the top of my pecking order just walked away.
That totally blew my mind.
Yeah.
It blew my mind.
You think a lot of people thought you were the mole?
I think so. But I think most of the people who thought that I was the mole are no longer here. And that was in the beginning stages. Now I'm not really sure who feels that I might be the mole.
What's your greatest talent there?
My greatest? Lying, cheating, and flirting.
I thought for sure she would stay. Mm-hmm. Unbelievable.
Anderson offered me an exemption if I didn't jump.
and I took it. Since I was picked to be the least favorite player, Anderson offered me an exemption, and I took it.
You know, Lavia and the mole just left.
People had been suspecting her, and the shock of her just marching out of the game was clearly a big shock. The most hilarious sight was watching all of the other players pick their jaws up from the floor.
I think, like everybody else, Lavia was right at the top of my list.
I guess the group will be missing their prime suspect.
It really surprised me. It totally threw me for a loop right there.
To quote my grandmother, you will always have lots of acquaintances, but you will only have one or two friends.
It was really cool meeting you.
Nice meeting you.
Yeah, it was really great having you again. You take care of yourself.
Yeah. You
can take me out to lunch in New York sometime with your 50,000.
All right, bye.
Let's proceed with the execution. In a few moments, I'll begin entering your names into the computer. Just kidding.
Oh,
not even funny.
I'm out of here.
I was just gonna grab
I'm gonna walk out without 50 grand.
I'll save you some time.
Look at that.
I love this game.
Because Lavia took herself out of the game, there is no need for an execution tonight. You have made it through another round. You will not be finding out how you did on the quiz. I know, obviously, you have a lot to think about tonight, and it's a whole new game. Have a good night. Sleep well.
Thank you.
Lavia, why did you do it? You know, you have such an upper hand. All those suckers out there, they thought you were the mole. I know that if we wanted to, we could have plucked them all off one by one.
Next Tuesday, the mole will sabotage any game, anytime, anywhere, even a game as dangerous as this.
So if the bungee broke, would the impact kill you?
Yes.
Mole 2, the ultimate spy game, continues.
Well, you guys are diabolical.
With fresh clues and a new episode, next Tuesday at 9, 8 Central on ABC.